Hello participant, welcome to the 5 days online course on futuristic accounting organized by Indian Accounting Association and Indian Academic Researchers Association. On this third day of online course, we are going to see forensic accounting. I am Dr. V. Dinadayalan, Associate Professor in Commerce, Sri Subramani Swami, Government Arts College. Forensic. There are two words here, forensic and accounting. We should know what is forensic and what is accounting. Forensic, it means suitable for use in the court of law and is a standard and a potential outcome that a forensic accountant generally have to work. It uses accounting, auditing and investigative skill to run an investigation for any case of theft and fraud. Here, this is the definition given by IACPA. Forensic accounting is the application of accounting principle, theories and discipline to facts or hypotheses at issues in a general dispute and encompasses every branch of accounting knowledge. According to Crumbly, the integration of accounting, auditing and investigative skill results in the special field is known as forensic accounting. Here, this is a simple, a pictorial representation of what it means by forensic accounting. So, forensic accounting is a combination of accounting, combination of auditing and argument of investigation to conduct a scrutiny in the financial report of a firm. So, this is the Venn diagram. It explains in a simple manner what it means by the forensic accounting. It is nothing but an intersection of accounting and finance skill and criminal justice skill. So, the forensic accounting is nothing but an intersection of the two things, accounting and finance skill and criminal justice skill. According to Hopert, Lanier and Young, they defined the term accounting, forensic accounting, as application of investigative and analytical skill for the purpose of resolving the financial issues in a manner that meet the standard quality by court of law. Forensic accountants apply the special skill in accounting, auditing, finance, quantitative methods, law, research, and investigative skill to collect, analyze and evaluate eventual matter and to interpret and communicate the findings. This is the timeline of forensic accounting. Early forensic accounting date back to the ancient Egyptian scribes who accounted for the pharaoh's asset, who were known as Eyes and Ears of Pharaoh. In 1817, the forensic accounting had its first day in court when an accountant was required to testify at a bankruptcy hearing. In 1824, a Scottish accountant advertised his legal accounting expertise. In 1946, Maris E. Philibert developed the term forensic accounting. In his essay, Forensic Accounting, Its Place in Today's Economy. In 2000, the Journal of Forensic Accounting, Auditing, Fraud and Taxation begins publication. In 2002, the Surfaces Actually Act established the Public Companies Accounting Oversight Board, which was charged with developing accounting standards, conducting investigation and ensuring the corporate compliances. As a result of the Sarbanes actually Act, there has been a continuing emphasis on forensic accounting. In February 24, 2010, the head of the prominent accounting firm interested with protecting the assets of victim in bankruptcy and fraud cases was charged with stealing millions. His firm used to specialize in receivership, litigation support and forensic accounting. In the Indian context, the history of investigative accounting, it goes back to ancient time of Mauryan times. Kaudilya was the first person to mention the famous 40 way of embezzlement in his famous Kaudilya's Arthashastra. Forensic accounting. From the above definitions, it's clearly defined as the application of investigation of investigative and analytical skill for the purpose of resolving the financial issues in a manner that meet the standard requested by the court of law. Forensic accountants apply the special skills in accounting, auditing, finance, quantitative methods, certain areas of law, research and investigative skill to collect, analyze and evaluate eventual matters and interpret and communicate the findings. So it means forensic accounting is detecting, uncovering, communicating and proving the fraud and other financial crimes done by the both companies and employees. Forensic accounting involves the following applications. A forensic accountant should have the following the areas of knowledge. A forensic accountant should have the knowledge over accounting, finance, economics, statistics, law, research, investigative methods, and one more thing is the computer knowledge, and finally you should have a communication of findings. So here the differences between the traditional accounting and the forensic accounting. Traditional accounting deals in the assessment of a business fund and properly conveying the information to the investor and the management, that is both the internal user and the external users. Whereas forensic accounting is called upon to investigate the flow of fund through a business for the purpose of evaluating the path they take care and determine whether illegal transaction have occurred. This is the presentation of differences between audit and forensic accounting. The main aim of audit is error prevention and detection, whereas the aim of forensic accounting is fraud detection. An auditor usually inspects a book of accounts in accordance with the generally accepted accounting practices, whereas forensic accounting evaluates financial document in an organization to search for an illegal activity, specifically white collar crimes. Auditor concentrate more on knowledge of accounting, whereas a forensic accountant requires a skill beyond the accounting, such as criminalistic, advanced data analytic, information technology and knowledge of legal proceedings. Next, we will see the differences between the external auditor and the forensic auditor. External auditor, usually he examines the books of accounts and other records such as documents, voucher, etc., which confirms or support the correctness of the entries in the book of a business or a concern, to enable an auditor to satisfy himself as to whether the profit and loss account and balance sheet exhibit a true and a fair view of the state of affairs of the
concern. Whereas the forensic accountant is a bloodhound of a accountant. These bloodhounds find out fraud and criminal transactions in bank, corporate entities or from any other organizations, financial record. They found for the conclusive evidence. External auditors find out the deliberate misstatements only, whereas a forensic auditor find out the misstatement deliberately. External auditor looks at the number, whereas a forensic auditor looks beyond the numbers. What is the need for forensic accounting? The need of forensic accounting is due to the failure of audit system in the business firm. As an organizational internal audit and other regulatory procedure fail to trace the error in the managerial system. It means the whistleblower are not blowing the whistle at a right time. So this is the need for the forensic accounting. Forensic accounting practices are, there are two major aspects. One is a litigation support service and another one is a investigative fact finding services. A forensic accounting expert measure the damages experienced by the parties implicated in a legal dispute and can aid in settling the conflict even before it reaches the courtroom. In the event that a conflict reaches the courtroom, the forensic accounting professional could give evidence as an expert witness. As an investigative service, a forensic accountant must determine whether the illegal matters such as employee cloning, securities embezzlement, including the tampering and the destruction of a financial account, identify the theft and the insurance racket have taken place. Scope of forensic accounting. The one is, the first one is, look for the evidence of unusual development in the accounting and the financial system. Design the accounting process for verifying important premises and data. A forensic accounting orientation also calls for skill in identifying the possible fraud. Perform audit type process on a routine schedule in order to reduce transaction processing risk, and cover a broad range of business and locations that require customary or continuous surveillance of all transactions of processing system. These are the objectives of a forensic accounting. To use a forensic accountant's conclusion to facilitate a settlement, claim or jury award for reducing the financial component as an area of continuing debate. To avoid fraud and theft, to restore the downgraded public confidence, formulate and establish a comprehensive corporate governance policy, to create a positive work environment. These are the objectives of a forensic auditing. Forensic accounting and its applications on various ways the forensic accountings are used. So these are the area in which forensic accounting are used. Number one is tax fraud, securities fraud, money laundering, family and marital disputes, business economic losses and bankruptcy, hidden or misappropriated assets, insurance claim, computer forensic or e-discovery, and terrorism and counter intelligence. So these are the area where the forensic accounting are used. We will see the one by one. So here the tax fraud, some individuals and business claim false information about their financial institution in order to avoid paying taxes. Forensic accountant trace the earnings to determine the extent of tax fraud that was perpetrated. Sometimes a forensic accountant may also use the data to prove that an accused company did not commit tax fraud. Another is a When the stockbroker or organization makes a false claim about the information that investor uses to form a decision, they are committing securities fraud. Forensic accountant works to help investor avoid these scams and uncover the companies engaging in security fraud. The 2001 Enron scandal, one of the largest financial scams to date, stands as a perfect example of this crime. Another is money laundering. According to IMF, money laundering has become a major global problem as it seeks to show illegal money as the money from the illegitimate sources. A forensic accountant can trace where the illegal money came from by applying his strong analytical and accounting skill to solve this crime, in which companies or people transfer illegal money into several small accounts or small amount and find out the original source of the fund by applying blockchain technology. Fraud can also occur within the family or marriage, whether it is hiding money or using the relationship to steal a fund. Forensic accountant helps get to the bottom of this situation. Although this crime typically exit on a smaller scale than a scandal, with the larger corporations, family and a marital dispute can still be quite damaging. Another area is business economic losses and bankruptcy. When a business experiences severe economic losses or face bankruptcy, a forensic accountant can play a valuable role in the recovery process. Failing business hire forensic accountant to look at their financial situation and determine if any foul play was involved in their economic losses. Sometimes these professionals discover evidence of fraud that can help the business regain its footing. Misappropriated assets may appear as embezzlement, payroll fraud, or property theft. Individual or business can also hide their assets purposefully, leaving them off of your balance sheet to keep them from another individual or entity. Financial accountant work to uncover this discrepancy and keep people and companies accountable for their finance. False insurance claim are a common way for the individuals to benefit from the lie involving a protection on their assets. Examples include a faking claim that may be difficult to disprove, such as a theft or a staged home fire. Forensic accountant carefully look at the fact surrounding this claim to determine their validity. Cybersecurity breaches have become one of the most common form of terrorism or counterintelligence, and a forensic accountant can help prevent these issues. Maintaining security in finance and tracking money carefully can limit the damages and help stop this attacking from happening. So this is a process of forensic accounting auditor, and this is the procedures. A forensic accounting audit requires different types of handling than financial statement audit. Each situation requires a unique protocol. This process involves an initial investigation. Second one is information reporting, and the final one is a final litigation. Investigation is the first process. So forensic accountants typically begin an investigation and collect the evidence when fraud suspicions already exist. Using the gathered information, they begin to form a hypothesis as to what happened and create a follow-up plan to continue to assess the business. Once this step reaches a completion, the forensic accountant determines the next necessary action and relays this information to the company. Second one is reporting. Once a forensic accounting professional gathered information or data and develop a case, they present a summary of their finding to necessary personnel. Using this information, this worker determined how the fraud occurred and who played the role. Then the accountant determined how to handle the case and suggest steps the company should take the next step. In addition, they may recommend a way to prevent this incident in the near future by increasing or strengthening the internal security and pointing out a red flag. Red flag is the warning signal. After submitting these their report, the forensic accountant prepare for their role in court proceedings related to the case. Litigations. The final process in the forensic auditing procedure. The final step of a forensic accountant process involves participation as an expert witness in the incident court of case. The professional presents their finding as evidence in court and testifies against the offenders. They explain any evidence and interpret the financial document in understandable terms, presenting how they identified the subject. Once this steps reaches a completion, the court determines the final decision for the situation. The forensic accountant play an important role throughout this process. The tools and the techniques used by the forensic auditing. Here, these are the tools. One is the benchmarking, ratio analysis, system analysis, specialist software, exception reporting. These are the different tools and the technique used by forensic auditor. Benchmarking is nothing but the comparison of financial result of one period with another, or the performance of one cost center or a business unit with another, and overall business performance with its pre-decided standard. Ratio analysis to identify any abnormal changes in their trend. System analysis is to examine the system in place and identifying any weaknesses which could be opportunity for the fraudster. Specialist software used just like an audit tool for data matching analysis. Exception reporting, it's a generating automatic unchangeable report that to find out a deviation from the norms. There are few prominent forensic accounting investigations was happened. It's what one is a Enron scandal, Lehman Brothers bankruptcy, the AEG bailout, Xerox fraud cases. So these are the cases where the forensic investigations are used to identify what happened in that cases. So these are the forensic accounting firms in India and as well as the international level. And Deloitte, KPMG, PricewaterhouseCoopers and Ernst Young, these are the and international entities in the field of forensic accounting. And this one is SK Jain firm. This firm has investigated the world famous Xerox fraud case by using a forensic accounting. Forensic accounting in India. The Reserve Bank of India has compulsorily made a forensic accounting audit mandatory for all the banks within the country. The establishment of a serious fraud investigation office in India has become the landmark for the creation of forensic accountants in the country. The indication of growing demand in the field, one is a growing list of online criminal offenses, breakdown of regulators to trace and detect cyber security fraud, failure of regulators to track the security scam, the long chain of corporate banks going bust. All are pinpointing the need of foreign forensic accounting in India. It's a modern discipline. Forensic accounting is beginning to see many avenues for the additional skill that go beyond accounting and finance. In recent years, the importance of forensic accounting has been growing rapidly. This is a professional field with a landscape that is being shaped by the rise of financial technology. Forensic accounting specialists do not only work for law enforcement agency, they can also found in the compliance department of a business entity, at a law firm, banks, government agencies. The majority of forensic accountants are hired by for compliance purposes. They make sure the company's finance are being kept safe and in good order. Nowadays, there is a acute shortage of forensic accountant skill set in India. A huge demand for forensic accountant has come up in the week of requirement from the investor after Satyam case. There are only about 400 forensic accounting companies in India. It's very less, approximately in India, $40 billion US dollar worth of frauds are identified every year. So therefore, there is a great scope for a forensic accountant in the near future. Thank you all for participating in this online course. Thank you, everyone.